Welcome to another Speed Pharmacology video. Today we'll be covering the pharmacology of drugs used in the treatment of osteoporosis. But first, let's explore the biological mechanism of osteoporosis development and bone remodeling to better understand how these drugs work. Bone remodeling is a continuous process that occurs throughout our lives and is essential for maintaining healthy bones. It involves two main types of cells: osteoclasts, which are responsible for breaking down bone tissue in a process known as resorption, and osteoblasts, which build new bone tissue in a process known as formation. In healthy individuals, these processes are well balanced, maintaining bone mass and density. Now, bone remodeling consists of several stages, starting with the resting phase. In this phase, the bone remains in a stable state with no active remodeling taking place. This phase is marked by the presence of bone lining cells, which cover the bone surface and help maintain its integrity. At this stage, osteoblast and osteoclast precursor cells are inactive, awaiting signals to initiate the remodeling process. Following the resting phase, the activation stage begins. During this stage, osteoblasts that have matured due to the influence of various signaling molecules secrete factors such as receptor activator of nuclear factor kappa B ligand, RANKL, and its counterpart, osteoprotogerin, OPG. These factors stimulate osteoclast precursor cells, which have RANK receptors on their surface. The interaction between RANK ligand and RANK receptor drives the maturation of osteoclast precursor cells into active osteoclasts. OPG plays a regulatory role in this process by binding to RANKL, thereby preventing it from interacting with RANK and inhibiting osteoclast activation. A healthy bone remodeling process relies on the delicate balance between OPG and RANKL. Now, resorption follows activation, and it is the phase where osteoclasts break down bone tissue by secreting enzymes and acids, including cathepsin K. As a result, calcium and phosphate are released into the bloodstream, contributing to the body's mineral balance. Key hormones such as estrogen and parathyroid hormone, PTH, have a significant impact on bone health by controlling the functions of osteoblasts and osteoclasts. Estrogen reduces the expression of RANKL, while increasing the production of OPG, thereby inhibiting osteoclast activity. In contrast, PTH plays a more intricate role in bone remodeling. At low intermittent doses, PTH stimulates bone formation by promoting osteoblast differentiation and activity. However, at high or continuous levels, PTH can increase bone resorption by indirectly stimulating osteoclast activity through increased RANKL expression and decreased OPG production. After resorption, the reversal phase begins. During this stage, the bone surface undergoes a series of changes to prepare for new bone formation. As osteoclasts retreat and bone lining cells reappear on the bone surface, a conducive environment for osteoblast activity is established. This marks the transition from the reversal phase to the formation phase. In this phase, osteoblasts are guided to the bone surface by various signaling molecules and growth factors. They initiate the construction of new bone tissue by depositing an osteoid protein matrix, which later mineralizes through the incorporation of calcium and phosphate ions. Sclerostin, a protein originating from osteocytes, plays a key role in managing bone formation by inhibiting the Wnt signaling pathway in osteoblasts, which is essential for their development and function. As a result, sclerostin acts as a brake on bone formation. This helps maintain a balance between bone breakdown and growth, ensuring good overall bone health. After the formation phase, the mineralization stage occurs. In this step, the soft protein matrix, or osteoid, created by osteoblasts, starts to harden. This happens as calcium and phosphate ions combine with the osteoid, forming a strong mineral structure called hydroxyapatite. Once mineralization is done, the bone remodeling process moves to the resting phase. In this phase, bone remains in a stable state without any active remodeling, and bone lining cells cover the bone surface to help maintain its integrity. This resting phase persists until the next remodeling cycle is initiated, maintaining a continuous process of bone renewal and repair. Having explored the complex process of bone remodeling, let's now delve into the different classes of osteoporosis medications and how they target various aspects of this process. We'll begin with RANK ligand inhibitors, a class of drugs designed to specifically interfere with the molecular signaling between osteoclasts and osteoblasts. Recall that RANKL is a protein primarily produced by osteoblasts and bone marrow stromal cells, which binds to its receptor, RANK, on osteoclast precursor cells. This interaction is crucial for the maturation and activation of osteoclasts, promoting bone resorption. In contrast, osteoprotegerin is a natural inhibitor of RANKL, as it acts as a decoy receptor and prevents RANKL from binding to RANK, thus inhibiting osteoclast activation. RANKL inhibitors, such as denosumab, are designed to mimic the action of OPG. Denosumab is a monoclonal antibody that specifically targets and binds to RANKL, effectively neutralizing it and preventing it from interacting with RANK on osteoclast precursor cells. By blocking this interaction, denosumab inhibits the maturation and activation of osteoclasts, ultimately reducing bone resorption. As a result of this inhibition, there is a decrease in the overall bone resorption activity, leading to a better balance between bone formation and resorption. This, in turn, contributes to increased bone mineral density and a reduced risk of fractures for individuals with osteoporosis. Building on our understanding of osteoporosis medications, the next class of drugs we will discuss is bisphosphonates, which include agents such as alendronate, risedronate, and ibandronate. These medications primarily target osteoclasts, the cells responsible for bone resorption, to help rebalance bone remodeling in favor of bone formation. Bisphosphonates have a chemical structure that closely resembles a molecule found naturally in the body called pyrophosphate. This similarity allows them to bind to the mineral part of the bone, known as hydroxyapatite. During bone resorption, osteoclasts not only break down bone tissue, but also take in the bisphosphonates that are bound to the bone. Once inside the osteoclasts, bisphosphonates inhibit an enzyme called farnesyl pyrophosphate synthase, FPPS, which is involved in the production of isoprenoid lipids. These lipids are essential for the function and survival of osteoclasts. By inhibiting farnesyl pyrophosphate synthase, bisphosphonates disrupt the production of isoprenoid lipids, leading to a decrease in osteoclast activity and eventually promoting osteoclast apoptosis, or cell death. As a consequence, bone resorption is diminished, allowing for a better equilibrium between bone formation and resorption. This ultimately leads to increased bone mineral density and a reduced risk of fractures in individuals with osteoporosis. Continuing our exploration of osteoporosis medications, let's now discuss selective estrogen receptor modulators, SERMs, which include drugs such as raloxifene and basidoxifene. These agents act as partial agonists of estrogen receptors in bone tissue, meaning they can activate the receptors but with a reduced overall effect compared to estrogen. This partial agonism allows SERMs to promote the positive effects of estrogen on bone remodeling while avoiding some of the potential side effects associated with full estrogen receptor activation in other tissues. By activating estrogen receptors on osteoblasts, SERMs enhance their proliferation, differentiation, and function. This leads to increased bone formation and mineralization, contributing to improved bone density and strength. Additionally, SERMs have been found to enhance the production of OPG, thus inhibiting the activity of osteoclasts. While SERMs stimulate bone formation, they also exert an antagonistic effect on estrogen receptors located on osteoclasts. By blocking estrogen receptor activation on osteoclasts, SERMs reduce their activity and inhibit bone resorption. This helps to maintain the balance between bone formation and resorption, preventing excessive bone loss and preserving bone density. Continuing our discussion on osteoporosis medications, let's discuss parathyroid hormone analogs, such as teriparatide and abaloparatide. These agents are designed to mimic the effects of parathyroid hormone, which, as mentioned earlier, plays a complex role in regulating bone health. Recall that parathyroid hormone can have different effects on bone remodeling depending on its concentration and frequency of administration. At low, intermittent doses, parathyroid hormone stimulates bone formation by promoting osteoblast differentiation and activity. This is the principle on which parathyroid hormone analogs are based. Teriparatide and abaloparatide are synthetic analogs of parathyroid hormone that are administered at low, intermittent doses, usually via daily subcutaneous injections. By closely mimicking the structure and function of endogenous parathyroid hormone, these analogs bind to parathyroid hormone receptors, primarily the PTH1 receptor, found on the surface of osteoblasts and their precursor cells. When parathyroid hormone analogs bind to PTH1 receptors, they activate signaling pathways that ultimately lead to increased osteoblast differentiation, proliferation, and activity. This results in an enhanced bone formation rate, which exceeds the rate of bone resorption, thereby increasing bone mineral density and reducing the risk of fractures in individuals with osteoporosis. Lastly, we'll discuss the sclerostin inhibitors. an innovative class of osteoporosis medications, which includes romosozumab, a type of monoclonal antibody. As we touched upon during the bone remodeling overview, sclerostin is a protein released by osteocytes that acts as a suppressor of bone formation by blocking the Wnt signaling pathway in osteoblasts. Sclerostin inhibitors, such as romosozumab, work by specifically targeting and binding to sclerostin, effectively neutralizing its inhibitory effect on the Wnt signaling pathway. With the elimination of this blockage, the Wnt pathway can function unimpeded, leading to increased osteoblast differentiation, proliferation, and activity. This boost in osteoblast activity results in an accelerated rate of bone formation, which exceeds the rate of bone resorption. The shift in favor of bone formation contributes to a higher bone mineral density and a lower likelihood of fractures for individuals suffering from osteoporosis. To sum up, a variety of osteoporosis medications, including bisphosphonates, RANKL inhibitors, selective estrogen receptor modulators, parathyroid hormone analogs, and sclerostin inhibitors, focus on different aspects of bone remodeling to reestablish equilibrium between bone formation and resorption. This ultimately results in better bone health and a reduced risk of fractures for patients living with osteoporosis. And with that, I wanted to thank you for watching. I hope you found this video useful, and as always, stay tuned for more.